So Christmas is coming, but the Melbourne Cup is here tomorrow. The big day, as always, on the first Tuesday of November.
And while the action and antics at Flemington stops our Aussie cuzzies in their tracks, Ellerslie also piggybacks on the revelry with a big meeting of its own. As Michael Holland finds, the flagship of our thoroughbred racing scene has been spending up big.
It's all about bringing back the grand, the sense of occasion and anticipation that these strains brought to thousands upon thousands of racegoers.
The call to post. I think it runs for a whole 4 seconds.
4 seconds?
4 seconds.
And you're getting paid, what, $10,000 or $20,000?
Oh, something in between there.
Another clarion call to spectators, Ellerslie's original tote board, installed in 1913.
That's what you call a crowd.
That is a crowd. That to me, though, looks like a very long wait.
You'd keep your couple of shillings in your pocket.
I would.
The board's refurbished facade now presiding proudly over the Auckland Racing Club's new $6 million complex of stalls and warm-up ring.
I'm so stoked with it,
so stoked.
It's a nod to the past.
This is a bit of a modern take on what used to be here at Ellerslie, and I think that's good. We've got a proud history in the racing game.
We're trying to bring back those things that made racing what it was, that made racing different. You won't see the bugler at any other sports event.
It introduces the horses from the birdcage out onto the track. It's a real festive atmosphere. The horses look immaculate and everybody there looks immaculate. They're dressed up nearly as good as me.
Because that's a brand new top hat, I know.
A brand new one. First day outing will be Melbourne Cup tomorrow.
Also making an appearance in his finery at Ellerslie's Cup meeting tomorrow, Ross Coles, who's been clerk of the course for 35 years, after taking over the reins from his father Ray, who insisted on grey horses escorting the thoroughbreds on and off the track.
Perception was everything, so in his eyes, grey horse, red coat, look the best, that's what we have. Never rode any other colour.
And now it's stamped in tradition.
It's stamped in tradition.
Speaking of stamped, a rummage in a back room recently turned up this rather chunky piece of silverware, which, after a clean, showed up a stamp from the royal jeweller, no less.
This trophy needs a race.
It absolutely needs a race. It's too good to be left in the safe, forgotten. But it'd be nice to get it up on the dais and to see someone win it. So a little known fact about this lift is it was built in 1953 to transport the Queen and Prince Philip on their visit here.
Probably their only moment's reprieve from the maddening crowd.
You do sometimes need a bit of solitude on a race day.
The Queen's lift saved them 5 flights of stairs. That's a grand old dame, isn't it?
Isn't it? They've rebuilt it really, really well. It'll be here for the next 100 years.
As will the grey horses.
As will the grey horses.
I almost called them nags.
Yeah, well, there's been the odd one of them too, but.
Love the bugle. I've got Sir Charles Rode in the TVNZ Melbourne Cup sweepstake tomorrow.
I've got number 14, Red Cardinal. It's going to come through for me this year, I just know.
Sir Charles Rode, New Zealand trained, Lance O'Sullivan.
Fingers crossed.
Mm-hmm.